Hello, I am Dr. Shantaram Kane, and this is the second module of part 2 of ketonics based super extracts for all. In this module, we are going to talk about the selection of super extracts for day to day human use, that is for your use at home with the use of Su Jok, Chakra and other combinations. This part 2 of the presentation is a story of my own explorations, compiling the experiences of a few volunteers and myself. The compilation of these experiences and opinions and analysis contained in this part of the presentation do not constitute medical advice and should not be construed as such. By using this presentation, you understand that the information contained in it is not intended to provide medical advice, but is intended to empower the reader to make his or her own explorations and then make his or her own decisions about using the information and own findings. Use of this presentation does not create a doctor-patient relationship, and before undertaking any actions discussed in this presentation, the reader should consult his or her physician or healthcare provider. The method of making super extracts described in this part and the list of numerous combinations contained in this presentation is not a recommendation, but an account of how I have prepared such extracts and their combinations. I am not a medical doctor, and I do not dispense medical advice or prescribe the use of any technique as a form of treatment for physical, emotional or medical problems. The reader should not commence any new medical treatment without the advice of a physician or healthcare professional. This presentation also does not prescribe or offer solutions for use in crop or veterinary applications. The intent of this author and this presentation is only to offer information of a general nature to help motivate your own quest for well-being. You have the constitutional right to use this information. However, you must use your own discretion and should consult a healthcare provider or any other relevant competent authority first, and assume total responsibility for the use of information and in this presentation. Myself, the author and presenter, assume no responsibility for any actions of the listener. So, what is in this module? First is how to select super extracts and Su Jok application areas for day-to-day use. This is for general day-to-day problems and their resolution. Combining oral, topical and Su Jok and Chakra applications, and what super extracts can be selected for long-term health, and how will you benefit? This will help you take care of yourself and your family, all day-to-day problems promptly with minimum side effects, develop a personalized package for long-term health, and enjoy user-friendly and extremely affordable health care available at your doorstep. Now, how do we proceed? First is a few ideas. We are given a few suggestions of what super extracts and the method to be used and explored. Remember, in all of this, exploration is key. Even if a specific idea is suggested, it does not mean that is the only idea that you should use. You have to learn to explore and find what combination of the extracts and what combination of the treatment package, that is oral, Su Jok and so on, works best for you. In other words, this is in keeping with the central theme of curiosity driven exploration. And that is what it is all about. Now, so method of use may include one or more, such as oral, topical, that is directly to a point, or to Su Jok chakra locations, and nasya, that is adding a few drops to the nose. Now, anecdotal feedback: more than one idea is given for some applications, and a person will have to explore which one before deciding what works best. And then, please learn to share your findings results of new explorations are to be shared within the group. That means within all those who are also exploring like you, to provide synergy. That is, we learn from each other. And believe me, when we do that, we generate new applications at a very rapid rate. And of course, that is useful for all of us. So, what are some of the common day-to-day problems that all of us face? First is the problems of the respiratory system. Simple things like runny nose, choke nose, migraine, then throat, throat pain, cough, and hypertension. Next group is the gastrointestinal system, that is, call it the digestive system, appetite or loss of it, constipation, loose motion, acidity, stomach cramps, piles, fissures, and so on. Not to mention colitis or IBS, that is irritated bowel syndrome. These two are the most common group of problems that we all face. We go out somewhere, we come home and we have a GI problem. We go out somewhere with in a sharp wind and we come home and we have a sore throat. So, this goes on and this affects our children, this affects us, and this affects the elderly in the house. And after that, the next big area is simple cuts, bruises, and burns. Of course, there are more serious ones like diabetic wounds and bed sores, but children when they are playing outside are going to fall and they get bruises and cuts. Even when you are cooking in the kitchen while chopping something, you can get a cut, or when you are frying something, an oil droplet will fly out and it can give you a blister. So, these problems are there, cuts, bruises, and burns. The conventional solutions, I remember in our young days, if there was a bruise, they used to apply iodine and it used to sting like anything. The very thought of applying iodine and children would start shouting and screaming. So, we want solutions, we don't do that. Then gradually, a large number of fraction of population faces pain. It may be neck pain, back pain, sciatic pain, which is really bad. I mean, you know, a person can be immobilized for several weeks with sciatic pain, knee pain, ankle pain, then also sprains or knocks, insect bites, allergy. All of these are common and we all face it. If you are in United States or parts of Europe, one very common problem is pollen allergy twice a year, in the spring and in the fall, and so many people suffer from it. Then there is an issue of general health, tendency to fall sick again and again, tendency for respiratory problems or cough and cold problems repeatedly. So, in other words, problems of general immunity and rapid restoration of health. Simple fevers and simple infections. So, all of these are areas of a concern. What is happening today, at least now in India, a child gets a sore throat, is immediately given antibiotic. And then the child gets a sore throat again after a month, another round of antibiotic. After 4 or 5 rounds, we all know what it can do. It can reduce the effectiveness of that antibiotic, and secondly, many of these will cause gastrointestinal upsets and distress. So, I think it is quite important if we can find simpler solutions, call them home remedies if you will, but home remedies are those which can be used directly in the house in a very simple manner and still take care of the problems. Now, this does not mean that you should never consult a physician. What it means is, at the very start of a problem, you use these simple remedies, and if they seem work, then you don't have to go for something more stringent. And that's the principle that we would like to follow. Now, runny nose often is allergic due to some allergy. Now, what we have found is, use garlic 10 or gulvel 1 on the palm at Manipur Chakra. Gulvel is Tenospora cordifolia. 1 is the strength of the super extract. Now, what is Manipur Chakra on the palm? It is 1 inch above the wrist, somewhere here. So, you just apply a drop and rub the two palms together. That is what you do. Now, a runny nose, if it is viral in origin with pain in the palate and so on, we have found use of calamate, that is Andrographis paniculata 2.5, again at the Manipur chakra, gives better results. Now, then sometimes, you know, you say, get this sort of pre-flu conditions. That means your nose is beginning to itch, your throat is beginning to itch, and you're feeling sort of run down. You feel that by tomorrow you're going to come down with flu. Now, one of my friends who is now in the US, he has explored and he has found that he uses garlic 2. He applies 2 drops to the bottom of each foot couple of times, and these symptoms just go away. That would be very interesting and very simple. I think the same thing would happen with red onion, possibly with ginger. But essentially, a simple use of a garlic, ginger, onion extract, few drops at the bottom of your feet and sleep overnight, and the problem is gone. Choke nose. Now, we have several solutions for choke nose. First of all, a nasya with ginger, ginger 10. I can assure you that many of these extracts, when added to the nose, they don't sting. So, don't feel that ginger will sting badly. It doesn't. So, a nasya with ginger, a nasya with what we call R5, that is the Divya Vanaspati, will very quickly and rapidly drain the choke nose. There is no question about it. Then, similarly, Shilajit, in a very dilute form, applied to Manipur chakra, also apparently has produced these results for some people. Pollen allergy in the US. My friend tells me, in fact, he now tells me he has used ginger 2, not even ginger 10. During the start of the previous pollen season, he started adding 1 drop in each nostril in the morning, and that's it. And there was no pollen allergy during that season. I think this is something worth trying, because it's so simple. You know, when you say ginger 2, it means there is only 0.7 milligram ginger converted into 1 drop of oil. It's an extremely low dose of ginger. It doesn't sting, and if it can prevent pollen allergy, nothing like it. The next very, very common problem is throat pain and cough. Now, there are a variety of solutions for this. One simple one is we have a combination called bruise. Bruise has several herbs, also has nano silver and nano zinc and a touch of neem leaf and silver. So, you take 1 drop of each in half a glass of water, warm water, stir it, gargle and drink. It works rather nicely. Or you can take turmeric 10, R5, silver, jeshtamadhu is licorice 10. Add to a cup of water, gargle and drink. Now, I know a few cases where what they did is take few drops of sesame oil on a flat surface, added a little pinch of turmeric, rubbed it with a finger and simply applied it outside to the tonsil area, and the painful throat disappeared. Even simpler thing. But then what is important is rubbing that turmeric in water doesn't work. You have to rub it in oil, few drops of oil, that is important. Water doesn't work. Now, we have some interesting feedback in a few cases that people who had lost their sense of smell by doing nasya with mool. Mool is the extract from drumstick leaves. In 2 weeks, the sense of smell returned, and the same effect was found by somebody else with R5 nasya. This is very fascinating. Now, in 1 or 2 cases, loss of hearing has returned by nasya with viso. Viso is ashwagandha extract and mool. Hypertension, we have a combination, that is amla 10, mool 10, PUGR, that is pomegranate 10, and RSR, that is the sarpagandha of old fame. This combination appears to be helping some people in controlling hypertension. So, in other words, there are a number of simple solutions for throat, cough, loss of smell and so on. And if you get congestion in the chest, we add trikatu, tulsi and parijat extracts. They allow the cough to come out from the chest. Loss of appetite. Well, in a very broad way, we use samavat, para, liver and rico are four of them, one drop of each twice a day. This is a very broad spectrum package for promoting appetite and digestion. But if it is not really a digestion problem, a simple appetite problem, we have had few cases of a child who was visiting India and he stopped eating. All we did, gave a drop of liver twice a day, and 4 or 5 days his appetite returned, because that liver drop activated the liver, I think. Mouth ulcer. The mouth ulcer depends on what the problem is. So, in one class of problem, giving samvat and para orally twice a day works on mouth ulcer. But if mouth ulcer is because of something just plain ushna, not really connected with a deeper digestive problem, we now have other solutions which would include an extract of pomegranate and an extract of the bark of slippery elm. These two drops each in a glass of water and you circulate it in the mouth and drink works within a few days. Loose motion. Well, we often get into this, we go for a party or eat something outside, we come home and you know your stomach is all gone. Now, what we have found is we have a combination called para, which is kuda wauding gulvel kirait nagarmotha, that is holarina antidysentrica, embelia ribes, tinospora cordifolia, svertia kiraiata and cyperus rotundus. All of these 5 together into one drop called para. 2 drops to the center of the palm and rub the 2 palms together. 2 drops orally and 2 drops inside the navel. Usually in 1 or 2 applications, the loose motion stops. This is really amazing. Not only that, usually after the, you know, sometimes when you really have bad case of loose motion, as soon as you go and come out, you start getting that feeling again that you may have to go again. Now, application of this mixture to the palm and all, suddenly sometimes stops this feeling within 5 minutes, that uneasy feeling. Again, to act hyperacidity, I given one combination here, that is samvat, haldi, neuro, silver, pugr. But now we have people who have explored that somebody who routinely had acidity, he is now taking PUGR-T1, that means the extract of total pomegranate, strength 1. He takes 2 drops twice a day and all his acidity problems are gone. He is not even taking all the 4. So, what I am saying is, this whole thing is in a state of flux. Whatever solution we may have devised 2 years ago, we are finding simpler versions or simpler ways to solve the same problem. This is why you have to keep exploring and you will find simpler solutions. Now, one other common thing is sometimes, and particularly children, immediately after a meal they say, I have a stomachache. This is with very young children, they have this colic. This is like a stomach cramp. And what we have found is that total pomegranate extract of strength 1, just 1 or 2 drops taken orally, appears to reverse this situation in less than 5 minutes. We had a few cases of hiatal hernia where the problem was solved by haldi, R5 and stab. Optionally, that can also be solved by PUGR and ulfulfu is that slippery elm bark powder. Then variety of food allergies, colitis and so on with samvat, haldi, neuro and para. What these combinations are is described in my book, when you download the book, or otherwise I will make it available to you if you write to me, that is not a problem. Piles and fissures, of course, important factor for piles and fissures is to properly adjust your diet. But while you are just retired, if you already have piles of fissure, then what we have found is R5 and Staphyl, that is wound 10 taken orally, appears to work rather well, and also to be applied externally if there is inflammation at the anal end due to piles or fissure.